Good afternoon. I am Sanjeev Afzulpurkar from National Institute of Oceanography, Goa. First of all, I would like to thank FCT, Government of Portugal, to invite us here as a special guest from India to seek what can be done in future. NIO Goa is a premier institute in ocean sciences in India, established way back in 1960s. We are celebrating our golden jubilees. And in that context, we are seeking opportunities and to collaborate with outside institutes, nationally, internationally. NIO is having multiple projects in geology, geophysics, marine biology, marine chemistry, ocean engineering, and instrumentation, which cover most of the Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, Indian Ocean. Since 1966-67, we have done a lot of work in these areas, especially in terms of gas reserves. We have helped in the government of India in identifying the first gas reserves in Bombay. Highway back in 1976, we also helped them in identifying some of the pipelines, etc., to lay from that to the shore. We have done some work for the Project Seabird, which is establishment of a naval base in Karwar, the preliminary works. And we have a lot of industrial collaboration which goes with the local industry. Coming back to research, we have done the extensive surveys for polymetallic nodules exploration starting from 1981-82. That has culminated in a mine site application and grant of mine site to India for all future mining. We also done a lot of work in marine exploration for ilmenite, rutiles in the coastal belts in India, especially of Maharashtra coast as well as the Kerala coast. So there are industrial opportunities that are. Now in future, where I am working? I am working in autonomous platform systems for to replace some of the routine kind of ship-based exercises which are done. The ship goes into the ocean, launches samplers and so on and so forth. But that's costly business. So if I can replace that with a robot, which can be there for some time, the ship can be doubled up. You have one ship and you deploy a robot, you can collect the data, the ship can go somewhere else, do its own job, and collect back the robot, and you have a lot of information, which is not only a one-spot information, but now it is. In that direction, we had a lot of collaboration with Dr. Antonio Pascoal from ISR Portugal since 2004-2005. And this has resulted in three technologies till date. The first one is autonomous underwater vehicle Maya, which we began collaborating and completed the technology in 2005. And we demonstrated that despite all the handicaps that were there, with this nice collaboration between Portugal and India, it can do wonders. The technology, the Maya AU, is still working very nicely. Past that, we started working on autonomous vertical profiler, which is to map the vertical water column in the seas or fresh water. And that project ran for about 3 years plus. The funding, of course, et cetera, coming from India, but the intellectual collaboration that was with the Portuguese group led by Dr. Antonio Pascoal helped us quite a way. And that is a big success. We have managed to deliver that product within 3 years and a few months. It is transferred both Maya AUV as well as autonomous vertical profiler to industry. Two pieces of this particular instrument, AVP, is already sold, and we are hoping to sell one more. So you can see that the collaboration has allowed us not only to develop technology for science, but is going into market. And we are hoping that this can take us to a much higher level. And that's why we are here at CNCR 2017 as a special invitee from Government of Portugal. And we are looking for opportunity not only in electronics or the autonomous systems. We are looking to partner in Ridges project, in gas hydrate project, or for that matter, some projects in biology, living resources. And to that effect, we'll be having a session on marine science, marine technology, and its interplay. What way technology and science plays to make more beneficial for mankind, we are looking for that. And I must say, without any hesitation, that this collaboration is quite a success, and we hope to have a long-term collaboration in this area, especially marine science and technology, to help us out, everybody involved, rather than only India or Portugal. Why not everybody else? Hopefully it will be market oriented, where industry will be involved.
So let me ask you, what are you looking for so much in the ocean?
As an institute, we are looking for many, many things. But for autonomous platforms to be more meaningful, the initial thrust is on looking at the water quality, the pollution, the biological resources, how they depend on the chemistry and biology. So we would like to first emphasize on that. Because India is having monsoon, which is seasonal, and it's very, very important for us. Because post-monsoon, there is a lot of biological activity and the fish catch goes up. So we are looking to have platforms or technology which can map out those things over a period of in excess of 100 days or up to 1 year. That is one of the primary goal in this collaboration we are looking for. We are also looking to collaborate in terms of deep sea, where we want to go to 4,000 meters to look at gas hydrates which are there beyond 2,500 meters or so, and the ridge tops, the underwater mountains tops, where there are special things which can be there in hydrothermal vents, etc., which can, the biology is very unique, so probably would like to learn for something in terms of special molecules which can be helpful in medicine applications.
So for someone that is not an expert, could we translate this that we are looking for in terms of the food and the energy and what else?
Yes.
Can it be important?
Yeah, this is primarily directed at looking at the food resources, because monsoon plays the most vital part as far as marine life cycle is concerned, in at least around India. So the primary objective is to understand monsoon, its signatures, its upwelling, there is the upwelling signature of that monsoon, and that affects in terms of, because very nutrient rich, low oxygen waters upwell from deep sea onto the surface. So we would like to understand that and then see what is the effect of that on the food web around Indian waters. That's one important part.
Okay. So what message would you like to send here in this meeting where India is the country that is the invitee, the honor invitee?
Thank you again. Yes, here are opportunities to learn many, many things. The expertise that is there in Portugal and the expertise in India and the opportunities that are there around India, Indian waters, is very great. So that is what I want to convey, that the opportunity exists for many, many institutions to come around and rally as a single unit to say that, okay, we can definitely serve the mankind, not only India, of course, or Portugal.
Does Portugal and India have similar seas or very different?
The tropical seas are quite different. Very, very different. There are a lot of problems with respect of biofouling, corrosion. The temperatures go up very high. So I would consider the driving factors are quite different compared to the Portuguese seas. The seas around Portugal or Azores for that matter, quite different. But that's a big learning for us in collaborating with this. And there is a possibility of collaboration for hydrothermal vent tube biology, where they are quite shallow around Azores, whereas in India they are very deep, 4,500 meters or so.
Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the event.
Of course.
And we'll see you in India.
Yes, of course. We are trying to make together an event which should last for some time. We hope so.
Thank you.
A lot of things to do with that.
Yes.
Because government to government, you have to formulate all those things. But we are hoping that will happen. Because both the prime ministers are driving it. I see both Portuguese Prime Minister and Indian Prime Minister are very keen on these things. And the Honorable Ambassador is very, very keen on these things. So he says, no, you have to be here and we should be doing this thing. He says, yes, we will do it. Why not?
Thank you.
Thank you for this opportunity.